If you couldn't get enough of Tony King, he joins us again from King King and Associates. How you doing?
Well, good morning.
Good to see
you.
All right, we got to get busy here. We got a lot to talk about. There's a number of different areas you wanted to touch on before we took some questions, right?
Sure. A lot of taxpayers are paying mortgage insurance premiums. This mortgage insurance kicks in when you purchase a home, a new home, and the down payment is less than 20%. Well, qualified mortgage insurance premiums can be treated as mortgage interest as well.
Okay. And then there was also something about the adoption credit?
Yes. Taxpayers can qualify for an adoption credit of up to $13,000 for adopting kids, and that credit can be refundable.
Now, teachers have some ways that they can get some.
Yes, there, and this has been a provision for quite some time now. There's an above the line $250 deduction for teachers for out of pocket expenses for classroom expenses.
Okay, and then what about the work opportunity tax credit for employers?
Employers are encouraged to hire, and if they hire certain qualified individuals, you can receive up to $6,000 in credits up to $6,000 of the first year wages, and if you hire qualified veterans, up to $12,000 tax credits of the first year wages.
And then giving to charity through your IRA?
Yes, you can also do that. A lot of senior citizens are withdrawing monies from their IRAs and making a charitable donation to qualified 501c3s. That withdrawal is tax-free. It's not subject to the regular withdrawal rules of IRAs.
Okay, well, let's get to a couple of questions here. First, my husband passed away in December of 2010, and last year I was able to file my federal as married. What am I considered this year, single or married?
First of all, sorry for your loss, but for 2011, you'll be filing as a single individual.
Okay. Next question. I did a rollover of a 401k from my previous employer last year. The company that managed the 401k overpaid the benefits, and my credit union took funds from the new IRA CD to pay them back. How do I report this on my taxes?
There really shouldn't be any reportable transactions for the taxpayer. The trustee will receive the funds back from the credit union, and the credit union will report to the IRS that this is a non-taxable distribution from that IRA.
Okay. And a third question here. I had to file an amended tax return because I forgot about some sick pay I received last year. My refund went up, and I have been waiting for the extra money. I received a letter that the tax was adjusted and is what I expected it to be, but the form does not say how much I am getting back. How do I find out about the refund, and how long does it usually take to get it?
Long question. Generally, with amended returns, they have to file by paper. You can't electronically file amended returns. Typically, in that situation, 6 to 8 weeks for the IRS to process the return, and then maybe another 3 or 4 weeks for the refund check to be issued.
And we got a little time here. What do you have any tips or tricks that people may not be thinking about that we can think? You know, usually there's some, like, these energy credits or things like that.
Those are still available. For those who have not filed the returns yet, my first suggestion is to pull out last year's return, go through that, look at the documentation, and then if you have not started to, make the appointments for your tax preparer, get in early because, again, season is it's approaching. And also this year, the deadline, the filing date is April 17th and not April 15th.
All right, get a couple extra days.
Yeah.
All right, Tony, thanks for joining us. So if we didn't get to your questions this morning, we will answer it next week, so keep them coming. You can email your tax questions directly to taxquestions@WBALTV.com or go to our website, WBALTV.com, and click on Consumer Alert. And if you'd like to get in touch with the Kings, you can call them at 410-486-4500. You can also check out their website at www.kingking.com.